Hi, welcome to another month of Thoughts on Leadership. This month, I'm looking at motivation. How do you motivate people? It's a great question. A lot of books and things written on it. I had an inspirational thought, which I want to share with you and the results of it with you, as something that may be able to help you. You see, as you probably are aware, if you've met me before, I have a team of there's five of us in the main office here, and we had a team meeting about a week ago. And at the end of the meeting, I said to the team, "I want you to go away, and over the next few days, week, I want you to consider how you want to be motivated, so that you perform at a higher level. So, what do you want from each one of us?" From each other to help you motivate you and drive you so that you will perform at a higher level. So that was my question. And my rationale behind it was this. We all get stuck in a rut. I mean, when we first start doing something, it's new, it's interesting, it's exciting, it's different. And there is the element of learning how to conquer it and try it and get it right. But then after a while, we get stuck in that rut where it's become mundane, it's become boring, we easily get sidetracked, we are trying to find other things to do. I'm no different to anybody else, so I'm not pointing fingers at this. I need motivating as well. So my thinking behind this was, what we need, if you think of that performance cycle in that sort of way, that there's the excitement, it's new, and at that moment it's still rising. And then you get good at it and it starts to get boring, your performance starts to dip. So it's at this stage here that we need to reinvigorate ourselves to a whole new level. So my thinking was, what do we need to do for each other to kick us in the backside, metaphorically speaking, so that we raise the level of our performance? In other words, we keep performing at a greater or better level, or at an optimum level that we need to be do to do that. So they went away with this question in their mind. And I found it very interesting because it made me think about myself as well. I was going to be no different from them. I had to come back to the team and tell them what I was looking for. And I realized that I would also get sidetracked with things. There's some things, parts of my job that I love doing, and there's other parts of the job that I find quite boring to do or quite hard work to get going. Often it's the getting going, and then once I'm into it, I can really flow with it. So what I need is help in just getting that first few steps, because once I'm rolling, I will just roll. For instance, writing articles. It's getting me sat down to actually write. Once I'm in the flow of writing, then don't get in my way. I just information will flow out of me and I can research and do the things that I'm supposed to do. But it's getting that initial stage. So for me, it was them being able to do that for me. But then there was also that business of understanding how I wanted them to appreciate what I was doing and recognize what I was doing and be proud of what I was doing. And I want them to be proud of me and what I'm doing as well. And so I need that from them, that they are proud of what I'm achieving. So that helps me then, keeps me motivated. So the whole process was one of thinking it through for ourselves. And what I'm saying is, I want you to sit down and think about this from your own point of view. Start with yourself. How do you want to be motivated? Okay? What do you, from the team around you, from the people that you work with, whether it be people at your own level, your peers, whether it be the boss, the line manager above you, or whether it be from the staff that immediately works with you or the team that you work with, what do you want from each one of them that will give you that kick and that motivation? Have you ever thought about it? Do you understand it? And most of all, have you ever explained it to them? Because if they don't know, then don't be surprised that they're not actually giving it to you. And that was the key to my question to the team, was by them going away and thinking about it and then come back and sharing it with each other, we learned from each other what we could do to help each other perform at a better level, instead of assuming that we all enjoy the same form of motivation. In other words, I like to be motivated in a certain way, and then my assumption is that everybody else wants to be motivated in the same way. Okay, and when I have that assumption, because it's my how I like to be motivated, then I treat other people in that way, but that may not be their preferred style. So the question was a really good question. How do you want to be motivated so that you can perform at a higher level? So start with yourself, think about what motivates you, and then think about what you need to engender that within your team. Okay, what can you sit down with them? Can you ask them that question? Can you explain this to them and help them understand that this is not something that you are doing to them? You know, yes, your job as a leader is to motivate your people, quite right, but it's not solely your job. Okay, so what do they need to do for each other, as well as what can they do for you? What do they want from you in terms of the way you motivate them? That will be ultimately their preferred style, if you like, or their preferred need that you are satisfying. So the questions for this month are obviously getting you to do two things. Internally understand yourself, what motivates you, what do you look for, what drives you and keeps you going. In doing this, think about times when you've peaked, if you like, when you've really been excited about it and then it's starting to wane. What would you need from people to push you up again to another level? And think through those questions for yourself. And then the second half of the questions this month is, how are you going to approach this and ask this of your people? Now, I was overwhelmed by the response I got from them. I was overwhelmed and delighted because, amazingly, they were very, very honest with me. With each other, not just with me. Okay. One of them turned around and said, what I'm struggling with is prioritizing my work. And so when I'm not prioritizing it, then I tend to get overwhelmed by it. So what I would really like is some assistance in prioritizing my work and being able to keep focused on the right thing at the right time. And so another member of the team who was really good at that said, well, I can help you with that. And those two went off and were able to do that. And another person they asked, you're going to be amazed at this, they said, can you discipline me more? You know, I want you to be more challenging of me. You're too easy. You don't push me enough. And I want you to push me more. And I want you to set me stronger deadlines. You know, so that sort of feedback, how would you like your staff to be that honest with you and come up to you and say, well, what I want you to do is push me harder. Or I want you to give me better deadlines. Or I want you to show me how to prioritize my work. Do you want them to be that honest with you? Because what I'm saying is, with the right question, you can release the information that you're looking for that helps you be more effective as a leader. In other words, helps get the best out of them. So that's what leadership is getting the best out of the people that you've got. So try it, see how it works, let me know how it goes. I think it's certainly been very powerful for us here, and I know others now that have used it and have found it very, very useful. I've got something else for you this month. A good friend of mine, a fellow speaker and a businessman in Canada, a gentleman by the name of Donald Cooper, shared with me something he saw in Forbes magazine. And it was just inspirational. And is in line of this whole theme of motivation, if you like. Let me read it to you. In a recent article in Forbes magazine, columnist Rich Kahlgaard delivered an excellent example of the human side of business leadership that is so often missing today. It was told to him by Nancy Ortberg, an emergency room nurse, who was finishing up one night before heading home. This is Nancy's story, as she explained it. She was finishing up her paperwork one evening when the doctor came in, and he was debriefing the younger doctor, the newer doctor. giving him feedback on how he had performed in the day and what he had noticed and what he could have possibly have done differently. Then he put a hand on the young doctor's shoulder and he said, "When you finished each surgery, did you notice the young man from housekeeping who came in to clean our room?" And the young doctor gave a sort of a blank look to the doctor. The older doctor said this, "His name is Carlos. He's been here for 3 years. He does a fabulous job. When he came in, he gets the room turned around quickly so that you and I can get our next patients in quickly. His wife's name is Maria. They have 4 children. And the doctor went on and named each of the children and the ages of each of the 4 children. Then the oldest doctor said to the new doctor, "He lives in a rented house about 3 blocks from here. They've been up from Mexico for about 5 years, and his name was Carlos. Next week, I would like you," saying this to the younger doctor, "I would like you to tell me something about Carlos that I don't know already." "Okay," he said. "Now, let's go and check on the rest of our patients." And Nurse Ortberg says, "I stood there writing my nursing notes, absolutely stunned." She says, "I was thinking to myself, I've just witnessed breathtaking leadership." And isn't that just a wonderful expression? Breathtaking leadership. Leadership, which is so simple, so easy, not contrived, it's just part of your being as a person, that is breathtaking to others. And I think simple questions, like in asking people, "What do you want? How do you want to be motivated? What can we all do for each other to motivate each other to perform at a higher level?" I think that is a simple question. And it's that type of thing that ultimately creates breathtaking leadership. So, I want to ask a favor of you. Have you got any stories of breathtaking leadership that you could share with me? Have you got any stories of breathtaking leadership that you could share with us? Donald and I were talking about this and saying there are so many good examples of breathtaking leadership out there, which could be an inspiration to others. So what we'd like to do is to try and collate some. So if you have any stories of breathtaking leadership, please can you email them in to us. We're going to start collating them, and if we get enough of them, who knows, we may even publish them and so forth, but we'll share them with other people. I hope this month has been interesting, has given you some thoughts, has challenging your thinking a little bit, and I hope that you are being able to raise your game as a leader month by month by asking these questions to yourself, considering the points that we raise each month. Once again, thanks to everybody who sends in wonderful emails to me. I really appreciate it. Keep up the good work. You know how I feel about leadership. This importance in our day and age is unparalleled. Have a really great month.